So now this is all glazed and it's all shiny, it's all top coated. We're ready to do the 3D work and any embellishment work that we're going to do. I'm going to start in the center creating the 3D. So I'm going to start by doing his hat and his dicky bow. So I don't need the rest of those nails for now. And we're going to use some greens for this. Match his green jacket. The ones that I've got out are Toxic Apple, Rainforest, and Secondary Green. I'm going to use the Speed Acrylic Liquid. Well, I work quite quick, but if you want to work slower, then use a different liquid. That is perfectly fine. I'm just showing you these colours on here now. So I'm going to do the main body of it. We can see where we've mapped out where the hat's going to go. Now we're using the rainforest green first of all, and I'll flip between using a 3D brush and a normal sort of size 6 brush. I'm going to bleed out the back, pop that on, and I'm going to push it where I want it. I'm just going to feather that out at the bottom so it's flat. Because then when I put another bead on, I can blend it up nice and easy. I'm not going to have any sharp lines. I'm just blending this and getting a nice smooth finish by putting quite a wet bead over the top and just sort of painting it over. We want the hat quite animated, so I'm just going to bring that corner out a little bit. Make sure you can't see the join. I'm going to heighten this corner just so it flows a little bit better onto the other nail. I'm not going to push them together and go straight across onto the other nail. I still want the nails to remain separate. I still want them to look like nails. Do the next part of this nail. I want it to kick out at the top, the same as this one. Don't try to push the powder, you know, don't try to push the acrylic until it is that, it's at that setting stage where it goes more of a satin finish, it's ready. If it's really wet and you try to push it where you want it and expect it to stay exactly how it is, it won't, it really won't. You need it to have a bit of stability to be able to push it where you want it. So I'm happy with that. The next bit I'm going to do is I'm just going to use this darker green. It's a different shade to do this ribbon. The fat piece of ribbon that goes around. And I'm just going to blend that down. I will paint it slightly as well, but I just want it to be slightly raised in a slightly different green. Let's see how that will go over. So just that bottom part there. And pop the bead on and check where it is. That looks about right. Going right to the edge. I want it to jump out a little bit. So it looks more realistic that it's wrapping around the hat. This top curve needs to follow this top curve. So the top of the ribbon needs to follow the top of the hat. Now we're going to do the brim of the hat. Start with this nail. Going back to the rainforest green. Going to do this in little sections. Doing this top part, well, this corner end, I suppose, here first. I'm pressing into the powder to create a dip, as if it's coming and curling around. Keep it clean. Make sure you've got nice clean lines. Now for the next part, connect the two together. Do that while it's still quite wet. Just brush it over. And pull that across. And I'm going to press it down a bit and then flick it back up. So we want to create some movement. I'm working on the next part. So I'll just check in how that's going to meet. Pushing the product up. I'm going to smooth this top part of the brim. Just put a little bit of the darker green under there. We're going to use a little bit of black powder to go underneath, just to add some shading, using it like paint. Same in here, tiny bit in here, just add a bit of shadow. I wasn't quite happy with that bit, I needed a little bead just to, that's it, just so it flows nice. So you can see this movement that we've got now. We're going to continue this over onto the other nail. So line up. Use your line here. I'm using this line so I can line up this now. Just going to press this out. Check the alignment each time. Because when you press the product, it's obviously going to move. So you need to check that you're still in line. With the black, I'm just going to add some shading. Also there by the ribbon. Using the black powder again, just going to run a little bit across the top of that ribbon. Just for a little bit of shading. And in between here, we will put his little ticket that he has in his hat as well. So for his ticket, going to use the soft pastel lemon. We're going to make this on a form. It's quite a simple shape. It's not completely straight. It's not like a card. It is animated. It has movement. So you want it to have a nice curve at the top. Nice straight sides. Coming down smaller to the bottom. I'm going to add a little bit of white, just to highlight, using it wet. Tiny bit of black paint. And a bit of water in it. See, we need the water in the brush to get it so fine. You're doing this before you put it on. Use paint on my 3D. If I need to do any 3D paint work, I will do that before I attach it on. That paint's dry because we used a tiny bit, so it'll dry really quickly. And I'm going to seal that just with a bit of brush on glue. With a little bit of clear acrylic, we're going to stick it on. So, take that off the form, and you can have a little look at where it's going to go. So I'm going to place it there, and use a little bit of clear acrylic to attach. Little bit of yellow. I'm going to blend this in so it looks like it's coming from the brim. With the black powder, I'm just going to shade that a little bit. And I'm going to get the glue again and coat it on. Just the ticket. Using the Toxic Apple, just to add a little bit of highlight. Now we're going to do his dicky bone. And we're going to figure out how big this bone needs to be. We're going to use Toxic Apple, which is really bright. Now, if you've watched my videos before, you'll have seen how I make a bow. Those that haven't, you can watch this now. So I'm judging around that side for half of this. So this size would be half of this size. We're creating a rough diamond shape. Release half of it off the backing and gently fold it over. And we're going to do the same again. And what we're going to do with the pieces, a little bit of the green, use that to stick them together. Then we're going to do the center. So we're going to press that out, create a long line, and you're going to push it back again. Long line and push it back and drag through the middle. So you get more product at the sides and less in the center. Just going to pop a little bit of acrylic in the center there. Pick this up, pop it on, and you're going to push it round so it's like a piece of ribbon wrapping around the bow. Now we're going to adhere this to the nail, just here. Small amount of clear acrylic. Pop that straight on the nail. Pick up your bow. Place it on. Press it down and then clean up any excess acrylic. Just going to add a little bit of black for shading. Tiny bit through the center. And that's his dicky bow done.